This is Ken Hanlon, the annotator for the Stefan Karlsson Trio CD Music Box. Extensive interviews were conducted with Stefan in the preparation of the program notes for this album. The following are excerpts from those interviews. The blues are ordinarily thought of as one of the essential ingredients in the genesis of jazz. Your composition, Illusions, is definitely of the blues genre, although there are some very interesting and inventive features in this work. Would you explain the process involved in the composing of this piece?
Well, when I started to think about the last piece that I wrote for this record, having three horns on the record, I needed a sextet piece. I started to think about my influences, and one big influence at a very early age was Oscar Peterson, who of course has a very bluesy sound to his style, and I just can't let that go. The title, Illusion, I didn't want the whole piece to be very obvious. I wanted to have something to it that really makes the listener pay attention. Maybe even have to really think hard about where one is and so on. When I finished that, I didn't feel like that was the only thing I wanted to do with the piece. I probably needed some kind of an introduction. Then after I started playing to try to get an introduction, it didn't really come out as an intro, so it actually will be part of the tune. But that was my whole idea about this piece, and I thought it was very interesting to try to bring in some of my early influences along with my more modern influences. And that is very important with jazz today if we want to try to take jazz to a different level or come up with something new that maybe hasn't been done before. We have to try different variations with feels and how we write melodies and harmonies, but still, you know, really have respect for the old traditional styles and players and so on. So that's sort of my concept.
The harmonic and melodic structure of your ballad, Blue Sky, is quite unusual. Yet it has a wonderful organic flow to it. What came first, the melody or the harmony, and how did you determine its inordinate length of 19 bars?
Well, the harmony definitely came first on this piece. I sat down and tried to come up with a very transparent progression. And then, basically, I was just sitting for a very long time, trying different things. And by doing that, I came up with different colors and sonorities on each harmony and different common tones and top notes on my voicings. And from there, I sort of decided what the melody was going to be like. So that's sort of how I came up with that piece. As far as the 19-bar form, that was, again, not intentional. After I wrote the whole piece, I sort of looked at the form just to have an idea myself what was going on in the piece. And I found that it's a 19-bar form. And first I was thinking, well, I don't know, you know, if I should have a 19-bar form, but then after just playing around with it for a little bit, I didn't really feel personally that it really bothered me, so I stuck with it. And maybe another thing that maybe saves this piece from feeling awkward in the sense that it has 19 bars is that I think at the very end I'm using this sus chord, sus flat 9 sort of a sound as a little transition to sort of finish off the piece, and that sort of mellows out and sort of evens out the bars in a way that it feels more like a standard 12 or 4 or 8 bar phrase. So that's at least the feeling I personally get from the piece.